American workers across almost all sectors of the economy are struggling. Over the last few years, worker productivity has risen by almost 17%, yet wages for nearly 70% of our labor force have remained stagnant for about 8 years. The remaining 30% of American workers have only seen their paychecks increase by about 3% in that same time. Workers are giving their all and getting less in return. But up on that top rung of the corporate ladder, CEOs have never had it better. Even when we had banks and brokerage houses going bust, their chief executives were rewarded with multi-billion dollar paydays while the American taxpayers had to keep their businesses above water. Just like former President George W. Bush, these corporate leaders managed to continuously fail upwards, leaving a trail of ruin in their wake. Joining me now to discuss the gross disparity between hardworking Americans and inept corporate leaders is Zoe Carpenter, a reporter from The Nation magazine's Washington Bureau. So Zoe, we do have these American CEOs out there who are driving corporations into the ground, pulling in these massive multi-million dollar paydays at the end of every year. And I think one of the most obvious cases, one of the most notable ones, is Richard Fuld over at Lehman Brothers. Tell us the Richard Fuld story.
Sure. So Richard Fuld ran Lehman Brothers, I believe, since 1994 until its collapse during the financial crisis. And in the 8 years leading up to the financial crisis, he consecutively made that list of the top 25 highest paid chief executives. And so he was raking in the money. Meanwhile, the bank that he was running was making a series of bad investments and then covering them up with accounting tricks and ended up collapsing, and that was one of the events that defined the financial crash. And all told, he took in about $466 million over those 8 years leading up to the crash.
And the whole board knew about these accounting tricks. I mean, this wasn't something that Fuld himself was doing. Everybody on that top rung of the corporate ladder there was aware of what was going on, and instead of doing something, they rewarded him for making it look like they were being very successful.
Right. Yeah. I mean, that level of cover up went through the whole organization. It wasn't just him, but he was very well compensated for helping run that firm to the ground.
This is not, unfortunately, just a few examples. This has become a growing trend in America, correct?
That is correct. So this new report from the Institute for Policy Studies looked at that top 25 list over 20 years, and they found that nearly 40% of all of our highest paid chief executives either ran their firm into bankruptcy or towards government bailouts or paid fraud-related settlements or fines, or were forced they were terminated against their will. So that's none of those are things that we would characterize as good performance or performance that warrants millions of dollars in compensation.
I had mentioned earlier in the intro is that, you know, this is kind of the same mentality that gave America George W. Bush. The man had failed in every endeavor he had gone through in his life and somehow still managed to continue to climb up and up and up. And that's what we're seeing with a lot of these CEOs these days. And so, you know, when you've got this gross income inequality in America, what does this do when we're giving people millions of dollars for being terrible at their jobs? I mean, how does that affect this income inequality and even, you know, worker, you know, mentality?
Well, it affects inequality in a lot of ways. I mean, one is the direct repercussions of the financial crisis. We're still feeling that, especially in working and middle-class families. Meanwhile, the pay has gone straight back up for CEOs. We're back at record levels for executive compensation. So we're seeing inequality widen. And there are these tax loopholes that are increasing that inequality as well. So there are a lot of ways in which it's not just that we're paying CEOs for poor performance, it's that we're paying them for poor performance and then taxpayers are having to pick up the slack, and that's increasing inequality.
Right, and that's a very important point, is that taxpayers are subsidizing this. We're picking up part of that tab. And so is there anything at all being done in Washington to maybe put a stop to this?
Yep, there are some bills looking at closing those tax loopholes. One of the big tax loopholes is that companies are allowed to deduct performance-based executive compensation, and that's different from a regular salary. Usually those are stock options, but those can be worth millions of dollars. And so there's actually an incentive in the tax code for companies to increase that, to increase those performance-based packages. And so there are bills in Congress to close that loophole and limit all of the deductions that a company can take for executive compensation. The other thing is we have already passed legislation in the form of the Dodd-Frank financial reform bill, and that just needs to be enacted, and regulators are really dragging their feet. One of the things that is in Dodd-Frank that would help is that it would force companies to disclose the pay gap, the ratio between what their top CEOs make and what their average workers make. And that would just make the system a lot more transparent so we could really see how much inequality there was in the system. And then it also asks regulators to figure out how to control some of the performance-based pay practices that encourage excessive risk-taking that contributed to the financial collapse.
So just to kind of summarize again, we've got, you know, up to $1 million is a tax write-off, except in the case of, you know, CEO compensation, you know, anything additional than salary. That's unlimited. There's no limits on how much they can write off in their taxes for that. Am I getting that right?
Right now, that's completely unlimited. So you can have millions of dollars of stock options, and your company gets a tax break for that. So that just that doesn't make any sense, and that's costing the U.S. a lot of money, about $30 billion. To do those, to have those tax loopholes in there. And meanwhile, we're cutting social spending programs that people really depend on and that they really need, like food stamps. And so it doesn't really, it doesn't contribute to a healthy society when we're cutting essential social programs and then giving companies a tax break for just continuing to give away millions of dollars to people who already have millions of dollars.
Well, okay, that's a great point there. Let's talk about people who have millions of dollars, billions of dollars, and are still getting subsidies.